I hope you all are fine and doing well. So I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry 2, that is BP504T. And we have completed unit number 4, that is industrial production, estimation and utilization of the phytoconstituents. And in this video tutorial, we are going to cover yet another important phytoconstituent, that is atropine. So let's start. So I hope you have remember this plant, because we have completed this plant several times. So atropine basically is obtained from different plants like Atropa belladonna, Datura stramonium and Hyoscyamus niger. So these are three different plants, and these all contain atropine as a major phytoconstituent in it. So this is your Atropa belladonna, this one is a Datura stramonium. Yes, this is Hyoscyamus niger, and these all belong to the family of Solanaceae. Atropa belladonna, Datura stramonium, Hyoscyamus niger, they all contain atropine and they belong to the same family, that is Solanaceae. So if we talk about its industrial production, so take an example of a plant. Suppose we have used this as a belladonna leaves. So first of all, plant material is taken, like if say in this case we have taken belladonna plant, okay. So first of all, we have to dry coarsely powder the belladonna leaves, and it is extracted with the alcohol, that is 95%, in the soft set apparatus. Yes, that is known as the hot percolation or continuous hot extraction. So I hope you remember about the soft set extraction. Yes, we will pack the drug over here. So main component of the soft set extraction unit includes, this is a side tube, this is a siphon tube. Where you will put solvent over here in the RBF. So when the boiling point of the solvent will appear, will rise, it will rise through the side tube, and here is the condenser is attached. Again, the vapors will convert it into the liquid state, because over here condenser is attached. Okay, then these liquid droplets will fall down into the drug, and your extraction procedure start. Means penetration of the solvent inside the drug, solubilization of the active portion, then escape out. Then over here is the siphon tube. So this will gradually slowly filled, and when the solvent will appear at this point, then due to gravity it falls down back into the RBF. That's why this method is known as continuous hot extraction or soxylation or soxlet extraction. So after the extraction, what we have to do, we will collect the ethanolic extract, because we have used here as an alcohol, ethanol as a solvent. Then we will concentrate it, and finally what we will do, we will dissolve it in HCl and then filter. I hope you remember about the addition of acid and base in the alkaloidal drug, because we have already completed this point. Okay, so you will concentrate it, and then you will finally add HCl and then filter, and that filtrate contains alkaloids in the aqueous solution and is extracted with PET ether. So what will happen, first of all, you will take, first of all, drug is taken, extracted with alcohol, concentrate it, then you will obtain a mass and extract, we can say here Sirpi mass, then you will add an HCl. So what will happen, it will form a salt formation. As we know, this atropine over here we have used leaf, so this drug is a mixture of different type of plant pigments like chlorophyll also. So we have, first of all, we have to remove that particular pigments. So what we have to do, when we add HCl over here, you can see here, it is written that filtrate contain alkaloids in aqueous solution. Yes. And then it is extracted with PET ether. Why it was extracted with petroleum ether? Yes, this is the answer. To remove the chlorophyll pigments and other impurities, we have to use a non-polar organic solvent so as to remove the impurities. Because only then we will obtain a particular compound in a pure form. Okay, and then we will, aqueous solution was made alkaline with ammonia. Again, we will add a basic solution into it so that the alkaloid will remain free now. Then it was extracted with chloroform thrice. And finally, what we have to do, we will combine all these chloroform extract, and then we will remove the chloroform extract using vacuum filter. Okay, or the rotary evaporator, and then finally we obtain the residue, that is the crude alkaloid,
it is again treated with an acid, that is oxalic acid, and then alkaloids are finally crystallized out, and with the help of fractional crystallization we will obtain atropine in its pure form. See, again this is very, very simple. First of all, drug is taken, extracted with alcohol in what? In SOX-CLAT apparatus. Then you will collect the ethanolic extract, concentrate it, and finally what you will do, you will add an HCl, dilute HCl, which was prepared in water, and then you will filter. So what happened, when you will add HCl, it will form alkaloidal salt. And yes, it is soluble in water. Over here it is written filtrate contain alkaloid in aqueous solution. So we have to remove this alkaloid from this aqueous solution, because we know alkaloids have tendency in organic solvents like chloroform. Like in case of caffeine, we have completed that caffeine is soluble in what? Chloroform. But over here, as the drug contain mixture of phytoconstituent, so we will, what we will do, we will treat this aqueous solution, and it was further extracted with PET ether. For what purpose? For remove the other impurities like chlorophyll. Okay, and then again we will use this acid base mixture. Then first of all we will make the aqueous solution alkaline with ammonia solution. At this stage the alkaloid become free. Then first we have to urgently use chloroform so as to capture, so as to trap this free alkaloid in the chloroform. So we will extract it with thrice. Then we will combine the extracts, we will concentrate it basically, and we will obtain a residue. Okay, and that residue contain crude alkaloids, and then we will treat this residue with again acid solution like oxalic acid. The alkaloids are finally crystallized out, and we will obtain atropine in this case, because we have used here belladonna plant. So I hope this is clear. This is very, very simple procedure for the isolation of the industrial production of the atropine. So next is identification test. We have also completed it, that in case of atropine, Vitali-Morin reaction is used, and it is in this test atropine is treated with the fuming nitric acid followed by evaporation to dryness, and with the help of methanolic cure solution which was prepared in acetone, basically a violet coloration take place due to the presence of the tropane nucleus. So I request you to watch the previous video. I have cleared the Vitali-Morin reaction at this point, at that point. Okay, then TLC method is used for the again the identification. We know in TLC we need, again it's a chromatographic technique. So yes, go for the stationary phase. So what is the stationary phase here? Yes, silica gel, but pre-coated silica gel is used. And mobile phase, toluene ethyl acetate and diethylamine in the ratio 70:20:10. And yes, for the detection purpose use dragon drop reagent, and the observation is done at UV 365 nanometer wavelength. Here is the representation of the atropine. Don't worry, we will do the structure in the upcoming videos. Molecular formula, over here C17H23NO3. It has a melting point of 114 to 160 degrees Celsius. Appearance of white crystalline powder. So next is the estimation of atropine. Again, we will follow simple method of the colorimetric determination. I hope you have now recalled this colorimetric determination, because we have completed this aspect also, colorimetric determination. So I acknowledge all the sources I have used, and we will do the next part in which we will study about the estimation and the utilization part. So thank you for your patience in listening. I welcome you all in the part 2 video of the industrial production estimation and utilization of the phytoconstituents. And we have started the phytoconstituent, that is atropine. And in this video tutorial, we are going to see the estimation of the atropine. So let's start. So the method used for the estimation is the colorimetric determination. So I hope you remember about this method, because we have completed this in the Diosgenin part 3 video. So I request you to watch that video of the colorimetric determination and then watch this video. So first of all, we will take 1.6 to 2.4 milligram of the drug, that is atropine, and we will make it alkaline with ammonia. And then finally it was extracted with chloroform, because over here the alkaloid become free, and it was extracted with using chloroform. And we will make up to value, that is 10 ml. Then what we will do, we will add 20 ml of the 6% this acid, that is acetic acid, in 5
5% ethanol.
So first step, what we will do, we will take atropine, add ammonia, extract with chloroform to make it 10 ml. And in this 10 ml, we will add 20 ml. Okay, we will add 20 ml of 6% acetic acid in ethanol. We will prepare acetic acid in ethanol and make up to 20 ml, and we will add this in this 10 ml solution. Then we will shake the, suppose we will take it in the flask, so we will shake it, and then from this mixture we will basically pip it out 5 cm layer and filter through dry filter paper. So what we will do over here, first of all we will take atropine, add ammonia, add chloroform, and then in it we will add this solution, that is acetic acid in ethanol, and then we will shake it to form a uniform mixture. And basically what we will do here, we will pip it out 5 cm layer. Okay, we will pip it out 5 cm layer and filter through dry filter paper. So we will take 5 ml 5 cm layer from this solution, and it was filtered, it was subjected to the filtration using a filter paper, simple. Then we will evaporate 1 ml of this solution, and it was subjected to the dryness on the water bath. And when it was completely dried, what we will do, we will add 0.2 ml of fuming nitric acid, and it was again evaporated to dryness. And finally, we will dissolve the residue in 3 ml of acetone and make a volume to 10 ml. Okay. Now, if you have remember this, what is this procedure? This is somewhat related to the Vitali-Morin reaction. In the Vitali-Morin reaction, we use fuming nitric acid and methanolic KH. Over here, we are also using. Okay. And then, what we will do, we will add 0.1 ml of 3% QH in methanol and allow it to stand for 5 minutes. And finally, we will observe our sample at 540 nanometer wavelength. And as it is a colorimetric determination, so purple color is our endpoint. When we achieve this color, when the purple color is achieved, we will do absorbance check at 540 nanometer. Again, see this. Again, this is very, very simple. First of all, we will take drug, that is atropine, because we have to do the estimation of atropine using colorimetry. So naturally, we will take atropine. First of all, we will add in it a basic, that is ammonia, extracted with chloroform, and it was again become subjected to basically to dryness to become 10 ml solution. And when this 10 ml solution is formed, what we will do, we will add acetic acid and ethanol in it, 20 ml. And from this mixture, we will take 5 cm layer at least, upper layer, that is 5 cm, and it was filtered. Okay, and thus from this, because this is only 5 cm, so then we will evaporate 1 ml of this solution, first of all, to dryness on the water bath. Okay, and then what we will do, we will add 0.2 ml nitric acid into it, and again subject it to dryness. And finally, we will dissolve this residue in 3 ml of acetone solution and make the volume up to 10 ml. And in the last, we will add again a basic, that is 3% QH, and allow it stand for 5 minutes. And we will observe the color change. Finally, purple color will form, and we will observe the absorbance at 540 nanometer. So I hope this is clear to you. That is the colorimetry determination. There are another two methods, that is the known aqueous titration method and assay of atropine. Okay. So you can also recall or remember this method, but I found this method is very, very important. That is a colorimetry determination. If we talk about the assay, so what is the assay of atropine? First of all, you will take 0.5 gram of the drug and dissolved in 5 ml of the alcohol, and it was previously neutralized to a solution of using a methyl red as indicator. And what you will do, you will add 20 ml of 0.1 molar HCl solution into it, and you will start titrating it with NaOH, and finally you are using methyl red as indicator. So this is a, you have to remember this, 0.1 normal HCl is equal to 0.02894 gram of atropine. Okay, so this is the important, you have to remember. So this is the assay of atropine in which methyl red is used as indicator, 0.1 normal HCl is used. If we talk about its uses or utilization, so yes, atropine, there are different type of marketed formulation of atropine are available, like atropine eye drops, then injections are also there. Please see this, this is atropine eye drops are there. This is again ophthalmic solution of atropine. In injection form, it is also available. This is atropine sulfate injection. Look at this. This is in the form of ampules are also there. So uses are ophthalmology, and antispasmodic agent is also used. If we talk about the general uses, so atropine is a prescription medicine used to treat the symptoms of low heart rate, that is used to treat the bradycardia, and also reduce the salivation and bronchial secretion before surgery. So as a pre-operative procedure, we use atropine. And I hope you remember about the atropine. Atropine is what? It is a anticholinergic drug. And we know anticholinergic drugs are basically used to decrease the different secretion of the body, like saliva secretions or the gastric secretions. Okay, so that's why atropine is widely used to decrease different bodily secretions.